One of the things linguists want to understand is how sounds work in the mind. And to do that, we usually look at speech. But what if we looked at music instead? Many classic songs would sound all wrong if just one word of the lyrics were changed. If instead of imagine all the people, it were manifest all the people. Or instead of California dreamin', Canadian dreamin'. Instead of at first I was afraid, I was petrified. At first I was afraid, I was suspicious. The real lyrics sound good because music is made up of strong and weak beats. The strong beats, shown by these arrows, are where you might clap your hands or strike a drum. And in these songs, the strong beats of the music line up with the stressed syllables of the words, as in California. In the alternate universe songs, they don't line up. We wanted to know how this kind of matchup between music and lyrics works in Filipino language music, because linguists don't even agree on whether the Filipino language has stress. Not all languages do. Filipino is the national language of the Philippines, largely based on Tagalog. And we're using that term, Filipino, rather than Tagalog here, because the music we're talking about is part of the Philippine national mass media. Everyone agrees that there are two kinds of words in Filipino. There are words where the second to last syllable sounds prominent, like puso, pag-ibig, pangarap, sino, and salamat, where prominence is some combination of duration, loudness, and pitch. And then there are words whose last syllable sounds prominent, like buhok, maganda, handog, ikaw, panahon. Some linguists think this means that, like English, the Filipino language has stress, as you can see in this stressed out face. Others think that instead, it has long vowels, like Japanese. Specifically, that in words like puso, the second to last syllable has a long vowel, which makes it sound prominent. And if a word doesn't have a long vowel, like buhok, then its final syllable only seems prominent because it's at the end of a phrase. And in this language, the ends of phrases are prominent. The reason we linguists can't agree is that stress isn't a single acoustic property like loudness or duration, but instead, it's a complex system of characteristics that works differently in each language. And in the case of the Filipino language, the characteristics could be explained with or without appealing to stress. We looked at 19 Filipino language pop songs. These songs were all big hits over the years, so we can assume that listeners found them to be well-written. The sheet music tells us which syllables fall on strong musical beats, like the ba on the downbeat of this song, and which fall on weak musical beats, like the second syllable, ki, as well as how long or short each note is. We coded these songs up, turning the sheet music into spreadsheets so that we can see how songwriters treat the two types of prominent syllables. The long vowels theory predicts that syllables like pu, because they have a long vowel, should tend to be placed on a longer note. But otherwise, there shouldn't be much difference among the syllable types. The stress theory predicts that both kinds of prominent syllables, pu and ho, because they're stressed, should get assigned to longer notes and stronger beats. And what we found supports the stress theory. Both types of prominent syllables, in blue, tended to be assigned to stronger musical beats, such as the downbeat, compared to the non-prominent syllables in yellow. It's just what the stress theory predicted. When it comes to how long the notes were, things don't look as perfectly symmetrical because there's an overall tendency for the last syllable of a word to be placed on a longer note. But still, syllables like hok are getting placed on longer notes than syllables like so, which only the stress theory predicts. Now, I mentioned earlier that some linguists think the reason syllables like hok sound prominent is because they're at the end of a phrase. But to control for that, these graphs here are actually only for words that aren't at the end of a phrase. And syllables like hok are still getting treated by songwriters as prominent in their own right. Filipino word prominence is a case where two different explanations seem to fit the facts, which made it hard to decide between them. By bringing in new facts from music, we found support for one of these theories, stress. All around the world, every day, songwriters are making choices about what matchups of lyrics and music feel right. And the more languages and musical traditions and genres we can learn from, the more those choices can tell us about how languages work. Thank you.